First of all, let me congratulate all the women here and all the gentlemen here from the three beautiful villages. I worked with a lot of women's group when I was with the Ministry of Women, Children and Poverty Alleviation. And I'm always marveled and inspired by how women at grassroots levels work. You're so good at multitasking. And I think you are the change that we need. You are not only responsible for looking after your homes and communities, you also look after the preservation of traditional knowledge that we have. You are the traditional keepers of what we seem to have left behind. As I walked in, I saw those handmade baskets made of coconut leaves. And again, going back to what the CEO said, that was how life used to be. I'm not going to say in the olden days, we're not very old, but that's how life was in the past. You know, walk across the markets, these were common sights. I remember my grandmother taking the baskets when she used to take us for marketing, and we used to put everything in those baskets, the bags sort of that was sewn. But suddenly over the couple of decades, what we have done is become so dependent on plastics. And our previous speakers have spoken about the harmful impacts of plastic, etc. So I'm just going to briefly touch on a little bit of research that we've done. Why plastics? What are the harmful impacts of plastic? I'm going to give one example. When I was reading through our research material, I was shocked to find out how plastics affects the sea creatures, especially the fish that we eat. The fish not only get choked by the plastic that I don't know how reliable the data is, but I'm using that as a research material. If we keep disposing of plastic at the rate we are going in 31 years, there'll be about 850 to 950 million tons of plastic in the ocean, and only 812 to 899 million tons of fish. These are serious implications of our actions today and the actions probably of the past. So what we need to do is to think about future. Small actions like that, small awareness things like that, small educational programs like this. And I must commend the Consumer Council of Fiji for initiating this. I know we are ending this the Green Action Week, but I'm sure this program will expand to other villages, and I'd love for it to be expanded to all my schools, because that's where education starts. But ladies, hats off to you for putting in the efforts that you've put in. Going that, see, people say that the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. We have to take small steps in educating our people. And if everybody in Fiji, we have close to 900,000 people, and if we were to change the mindsets of each one of our people here, only in Fiji, can you imagine the impact that we will have in terms of reducing plastic pollution in Fiji? So how do we reduce our single plastic bag consumption is, of course, how do you do that? You've just started that. I mean, as governments, we put a duty, we put a levy on plastic. Plastic, we've increased it to, now it's increased to 50 cents, but by 2020, we expect to completely phase out the use of single. What are the alternatives for that? This is one option, but I think we need to put more effort in making sure that the options that we give to our people are more durable, probably in contrast to plastic. It has to be something that's going to appeal to people. And going back to nature, making bags or carrying material out of recycled material, and not using plastic at all. I'll just give an example. The water in that is Fiji water, but it's packed in a bottle. So if each one of us was supposed to do that, I'm sure we will make a lot of difference. And you've heard that. This is not only a problem for Fiji or in the Pacific. It's a global problem. It's a global problem. So globally, efforts are being made. We have NGOs. We have those organizations that fund this program. But our focus here should be more on educating our people so that action starts at individual level. If every family was to take their own shopping bag, I don't know how much difference does it make? I mean, I'm guilty of sometimes forgetting to take mine, because it's something that we are not used to. So we have to get used to it. We have to say, let me take a glass and get open the tap and drink from that, rather than picking up a water bottle and drinking. It's change of habits. It's changing mindsets. And we will need to change mass mindset. A couple of people have started this, groups and NGOs have started it, but what about the rest of us here in Fiji and in the Pacific? And so again, if you look at the Green Action Fund 2019, I think it goes very well with our government's initiative. We want to reduce single-use plastic bags and seek healthier and environment-friendly alternatives. We want to enhance the resilience of marine and coastal ecosystems to climate change. Of course, you hear about this word sustainable living. We want to promote sustainable living, and we want to move forward the green consumerism agenda and to encourage the use of consumer-friendly products. Ladies and gentlemen, in Fiji, we have 1,000 coral reefs with an extensive and high diversity of marine habitats, where approximately 80% of Fiji's population live on the coastline. A lot of our communities depend on the coastal and the maritime areas that they live in. And sadly, what's happening? The spectacular reef ecosystem has now been degraded by the compounded effects of plastic pollution. In 2010, it was projected that Fiji used approximately 10 million plastic bags, of which large portion ended up in catchments, streams, and eventually into our oceans. This decade-old report is so alarming. Imagine what the figures will look in 2020 and beyond. Now that is something for us to be serious about. Ladies and gentlemen, brace yourself for these statistics if you are a fish lover. 97% of all fish sampled had microplastics. Shocking. That is 30% higher than the global average. Now, after reading these reports and after knowing these statistics, I'm sure you and I would be very cautious about eating fish, because most of us are fish lovers. And most of our Pacific Island people sort of survive on that. So are we going to put fish on our menus? Again, that's our livelihood as well. It may sort of be a laughing matter. Oh, okay. How does plastic affect fish? It does. So education, again, plays a very important role here. So one way, in another way, the over or consumption of plastics, poor disposal of plastics is sort of a direct threat to our food security in the Pacific and, of course, globally as well. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, this cannot be curbed individually, and the entire community needs to rally behind each other. And there we have three communities, very strong communities who've taken it upon themselves to find alternatives to plastics, and they must be commended. And I'm sure they will inspire other communities across Fiji to join in our efforts to curb this problem. Ladies and gentlemen, this project is targeted at sharing of traditional knowledge and mediums to create alternatives to replace plastics, and of course emphasize on the concept of sharing, reducing, reusing, replacing, and recycling. As the problem intensifies, I think we are compelled to move beyond just the three R's and extend our R's into that. Of course, you might say we consumers have rights. It is true. While we consumers have rights, we also have responsibilities. We have responsibilities towards our environment. We have responsibilities towards our future generations as well. The environment is for us to use and not for us to abuse. But it is clearly evident that we have not been very mindful of the impacts that our actions have had on our environment for decades and for centuries. And again, I think we don't have a lot of time to waste. What we need is action. Enough of talk. We need to act. And small actions like this, ladies and gentlemen, will take us a long way. Like I said to the Consumer Council, I'd love for these projects to be part of our education system, where we have our kindergarten children, they can be involved in our primary school children and our secondary school children. Close to 237,000 students we have in Fiji. Imagine if we can impact their mind. What difference are they going to make, right? So we would love to work with you in ensuring that we bring back traditional methods into our lives again. Ladies and gentlemen, the World Meteorological Center reports the rise of Earth's surface temperature, that too by 0.7 degrees Celsius, caused by you and me and many other millions and billions of people across the globe. Every time we release excessive carbon and other greenhouse gases into the atmosphere, we exhaust fuel and forest every minute to generate power, money, and 30 billion tons of carbon. That's shocking. The world, of course, is a global village, and immediately curbing growing environmental degradation is our responsibility. The fish in our oceans are craving for oxygen. They are throttled by plastic, choked by fertilizers and biomass sludge. What are we going to do about it? Ladies and gentlemen, we sign treaties, NGOs and governments, which sign treaties and protocols and invest substantial funds in attending climate change meeting and conferences. In fact, our Honorable Prime Minister is taking an international lead role and his familiar face on the world arena as one of the best climate ambassadors, and we all must really be behind him. Yet, on such a high-profile mission, why is the world still facing this impending crisis? Maybe we're still not taking it seriously as we are supposed to take it. Dear listeners, all the efforts of our organizations, our funding partners, our donor partners, our NGOs, our individuals will be paid off with a conviction, a deep conviction that yes, we mean business. We are serious about what we are doing to our environment. Without a deep-rooted conviction, it's all going to be worth. And of course, conviction and commitment, two C's. Conviction and commitment will definitely make a difference. Probably not at a global level, but here in Fiji on a smaller scale, in the Pacific on a smaller scale, we all can and must believe that we can make a difference. Each and every one of you possesses the power to change the course of nature. Our women have shown it. Our children can show that. Our NGOs have shown it through their conviction and commitment. And we all must pledge that, yes, we have the power to walk with nature and not walk against nature. As members of the global family, let's take these few simple yet very bold steps. Let's see what are simple things that we can do. How do we conserve energy? We make every hour Earth hour. We switch off our vacuum cleaners and pick up the good old Sasa broom. Ladies, that's more business for us. We need to go back to the Sasa broom. Let's save energy there. Take a walk and take your own shopping bag to the supermarket. Whenever we want to shop, sometimes we feel like shopping 2-3 days in a daytime, we start up our car and we go. Let's plan our shopping. Okay? Simple switches that we can do. Plastic food container to stainless steel lunch boxes. Forget about those disposable plastic containers that we have. Have one lunchbox. It may cost you now, but in the longer run, that's an investment. Plastic water bottles too? Steel tumblers or glass bottles. Paper towels as sandwich wrap to reusable cotton wraps. Plastic straws to reusable bamboo or metal. So let's all carry our own straws with us when you go to the supermarket. Simple things. But again, it's the habit that we have accumulated since we were children. We go to the supermarket, we go to the restaurant, we go here, we know we'll be given that. It's probably a change in the mindset and our habits that needs to change. So at the Ministry of Education, what we do is we partner with the Department of Energy and Environment, and we run a number of competitions in schools to create awareness. I know it's a start, but it's not enough. We really need to do more on that. So ladies and gentlemen, our Honorable Prime Minister announced at the World Leaders for Nature event in New York, I think that's last week, that Fiji will plant 30 million trees over the next 15 years. And I'm sure you and I and everybody together should be able to achieve that. Very ambitious, but we have to work towards that. Fiji planting 30 million trees over the next 15 years. Wow, that's an average of 2 million trees per annum. So get busy, Fiji. You've got to get busy now. Right, there's a lot of work to be done, and we have to do that. And our Prime Minister also recently was joined by Aquaman and a 16-year-old from Sweden, Greta, the UN, speaking for the billions of young people around the world who will inherit the planet that we hand them over. Let's think about what we're going to leave for our children. Are we going to leave an ocean, what, bogged up with plastics for our younger generation? Are we going to leave fish that is contaminated with toxic for our future generation? I'm sure we don't want to do that. It's our children we are talking about. So we really have to get busy with that. And we all need to step up, ladies and gentlemen, and contribute to fighting climate change in whichever form, whichever way we all can do. If individuals and communities together can make a difference, of course, nations combined will turn the tables. We talk a lot about renewable energy in Fiji, but often it is unaffordable by many. I recommend that businesses and corporate organizations help make solar energy more affordable. I urge business houses to come up with higher purchase schemes where complete solar packages can be sold, installation charges included, at an affordable price for families to be able to afford that. Let's take awareness and action very seriously. Today, you know, we normally hear and say that our Mother Earth is weeping for our survival, her heritage. Slowly, humanity is becoming a threatened race, and that includes you and me. We are part of that race that is threatened. Ladies and gentlemen, despite all this that's happening around us and around the globe, at a global level, if we still go back home and continue to have a normal life, believe me, efforts, funding, awareness campaigns for any project regarding environmental conservation will go to a waste. If we continue to behave the way we've behaved, if we continue to disregard our use of plastics, if we continue to damage our environment at the rate we've done, and we act normal, nothing's going to change. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, before I take my seat, I'd just like us to be more informed, take back home messages from our two speakers and the Consumer Council. Has to be taken very seriously. Be aware of what's happening around you. Let's all follow these women from Serua and Sanivethi and Galoa and many, many others who are doing their bit in a smaller way. Those that have not come to a platform like this to be recognized. I'm sure you're doing a little bit in your own villages and homes. And there are many, many other men and children who are doing their share, planting a tree. We will not be able to bring that everybody to a platform like this to honor and congratulate and thank them. But I'm sure there's so many out there who are doing their bit, and let us all do our bit. Not to get a reward, but just do the bit as our contribution to our Mother Nature. Ladies and gentlemen, nature is ours. Let's claim it. And once again, to all the women and men from the three villages and Consumer Council of Fiji and all your partners, all the NGOs that work with Consumer Council, thank you very much for your efforts. Very much appreciated. And I'd like to wish you all good health and success in your future endeavors. And let us continue this fight. Fight for our survival. Fight for the survival of our future generation. Fight for the survival of our cultures and our traditions and our heritage as long as we can. May the good Lord bless you with richness of strength, richness in mind, deeper commitment and deeper conviction that yes, we can all stand up proudly and say, we did our part. We did our part to save our environment. We did our part to save our resources for the future generation, our children. So thank you very much, and God bless you. You can come back.